I have often lost purpose choosing between practice and pragmatism. What we see is what we do, but what we are supposed to is not always what we see. With a lot of pride, I conduct my daily practices. These practices, which are a result of a thought. These thoughts, which are eventually the consequence of a mentality. Throughout the day, I come across a variety of thoughts where logic is always an exception to practice. Realism is nothing close to what we learn in schools, colleges, or from our teachers. In fact, it is just the inheritance of a mentality which is again the result of extremities. Take an example, patriarchy. Does anybody out here have a logical reason why we follow a patriarchal society except for the fact that it's been continued since ages? Our ancestors told us, our grandparents told us, our parents also taught us the same thing, and that is why we are continuing with it. According to me, adulthood is the unveiling of reality. It is the only time when realization can dawn upon an individual and simultaneously he can choose to act upon it. But. Most of the individuals, knowing or unknowingly, jump into a loop of practices which after a point they are afraid to discontinue. Only a handful of people possess the ability to question their practices, because the rest are initially pushed by peer pressure, later in life they are driven by fear pressure. A nice nin once said, when we blindly accept a religion, a political system, or a literary dogma, we turn into automatons, robots. Why do you think we do this? We need to unlearn our righteousness because we are already brainwashed with a million instructions. Our decisions are a choice of sides. We first listen to a bunch of people and then decide upon whom to choose and not why. Why do you think we do this? What is the reason? Ownership. Ownership is the reason. Because when you take an independent decision, an individual needs to own up to the consequences of that decision. Ownership comes with responsibility. And responsibility leads to success. Ownership is the product of success. When my first storytelling video came out, at that time my father was critically ill and my family finances were at an all-time low. That is when I asked my father, would he like me to rather take care of my family and forego my passion for storytelling? To which he gave me a very simple reply. No. I want you to pursue your career, your dream with all the grit in you. As you grow, you will fall, you will fail. At that time, there will be more people pelting stones at you than showing support. But you have to ensure you do not hold anyone else responsible in case you fail. Because acceptance alone will hold you strong. Eventually, you're accountable only to yourself. You know, it is very easy to be drawn into and pushed by the herd mentality. The temptation to reaffirm our thoughts, our beliefs is irresistible. Moreover, the blame game is the easiest way to swim through life. Because when reality hits an individual and it starts daunting upon him, he's already buried under a bunch of liabilities and responsibilities which he probably didn't even want in the first place. Take an example. His EMIs, his loans. You understand an education loan. You understand probably a home loan. But what is a marriage loan? He's afraid of this fictitious world that he's created around himself, which consists of whom? His family, his friends, And of course, the so-called society which he's probably never witnessed, but he's afraid of. The fear of everything falling apart overshadows his moment of realization, because of which he remains a robot, practicing the same practices again and again. As a result, these are the same teachings he passes upon his next generation. Take a moment. Think if you want to be a prey to this kind of a society or a system. My dear friends, today when you leave from here, I don't want you to leave thinking I was right. I want you to think. I want you to inculcate the habit of thinking. Because plain acceptance is lethargy. Questioning is thinking. And thinking is the start of redefining our perspectives. It is the start of realization hitting upon us. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Krishna Iyer. Professionally, I'm a corporate slave. That's what I call myself. Otherwise, I'm a storyteller. And today, I am here to share with you a story that has changed my life, that has changed my perspective towards life. To look at the bigger picture of life. As a kid, I was a very smart kid. I could complete and do everything that I wanted to do. Of course, all the speed and smartness was followed by overconfidence. I was a highly overconfident and over-optimistic kid. In school, I was that kid who never had an ambition. When teachers asked students, what do you want to become in future? My friends were like doctors, scientists, astronauts, engineers. And when my turn came, I was just like, I don't know. I don't have a concrete ambition. I just want to be a happy person. Even now, when I look back and I think, the amount of education we get in primary schools, how do you even decide what do you want to become? You're learning the basic of math and grammar. And what you eventually become is far different. But since I joined school, I always had one ambition at that time, was I wanted to become the head boy of my school. For me, that was the biggest milestone that I could achieve when I was in school. When students were studying, if you talk about academics, I aced it in school. I was a distinction student. I never wanted or aspired to be a first ranker. I was rather more interested in participating in every activity that the school conducts. Talk about cultural activities. You talk about public speaking, debates. By the time I reached the end of my school life, I had probably won every literary award possible in my school. I was the apple of every teacher's eyes. And yes, I did become the head boy of my school. Like they say, the universe conspires for you to achieve what you have always wanted. I did achieve that. But life probably had a different plan for me. Cut to 3 months from when I became the head boy of my school. One day I half open my eyes, I can see the ceiling fan, which is higher than usual, which makes me realize this is not my home. I feel a lot of weakness in my body. I look towards the right side, I see something like a heart monitor, a few other machine sort of things. I look towards my left side, I look at my parents standing, my relatives standing and smiling at me. I have no idea what has happened, why am I there? What is this place? I ask my father tells me, you have woken up after 40 days. I'm like, 40 days, what? Because I had no memory of when did I go to sleep. Was it the day? Was it at night? When in the time did I go to sleep? I have no memory of this. And then my dad told me, I had an accident. an accident that kept me under ventilation for 40 days. I was like, okay, probably I'll get up and I'll be fine. However, like I told you, I have been this overconfident and over-optimistic kid, and I decided I'm not going to let the nurses do all my activities or help me out. I myself will go and do whatever I want to do. So that day, I decided I was going to the restroom myself, taking no help of the nurses and nobody. Everything will be done all by myself. With shaky legs, I got down from the hospital bed. With trembling feet, I somehow walked towards the washroom. While I thought this was the most difficult journey of my life or the most miserable journey, I looked at myself in the mirror. A bald head, a black bruised forehead, a mark on my forehead which had dried blood of stitches on them. All this at the cost of not knowing what had happened. But what I saw next in the mirror completely broke me from within. An eye that would half open with a hampered vision, and when I looked down, it'll abruptly behave. Imagine tonight you went to sleep as a normal person, and the next day when you woke up, you look like a sham without even knowing what has happened to you. That moment, right there, I broke down and I sobbed. It took me about 2 minutes, I collected myself and I walked back. I turned around to open the door of the washroom and misjudgment number one, the door slammed on my face. However, the doctors told me within 6 months my eye had to open. After a few days, I was back home. It was 3 months now. With every day, I was discovering a new disability. Like at one point, I used to be a cricketer who used to find the ball in pitch darkness. But today, if you threw something towards me, I would duck. I would be afraid. At that time, if I had to walk somewhere to collect something, it would take me 2 minutes to judge the way. 3 months passed, 6 months passed. My eyes still hadn't opened. But at that time, I had become more mobile. And that is when I started meeting people. And in life, people always tell you what is the reality of your life. There was one kind of people that I met who felt bad for me but never showed it. Then came the second kind who felt so bad for me that I had to think, oh my God, what will I do? Then came the third kind who would shove it up my face. Bro, you've met with an accident. What is going to happen to your life? And I have always been a confident kid. I have never had a problem with taking initiatives or taking decisions. But at that time, I started losing my confidence somehow. And that is when, I'm not sure if I told you, it was my 10th standard. And we all know how much importance we have given to SSC in our life. People started telling me, you don't give the exam, don't worry. It's just 1 year. You have been a bright student. What if you fail? Then you will go under depression. Just let it be. And I started questioning myself at that point in time. So this one day I was with my dad. I asked him, Appa, what if I fail? My dad tells me, what if you fail? What is wrong? Imagine that part, you didn't even give an attempt and you failed. Are you going to regret that for all of your life? Or was this the reason why you were chosen as a leader or the head boy of your school among 300 kids? That talk kind of moved me. That night, I didn't sleep. I kept contemplating. I had 1 month in my hand. I studied for the exams and I even gave those exams. Cut to 3 months, a night before the results. I'm filled with anxiousness. I am worried what is going to happen In one night, I drink almost 1.5 liters of coffee. For 15 times, I would have visited the washroom. I'm rolling on the bed thinking, maybe I shouldn't have given the exam. Now, if I fail, I'll look like a fool. No, let's stay positive. We might clear it. Next day, 10:30, I'm sitting in front of the PC. 11 o'clock, Mumbai University results are showcased. I'm sitting there from 10:30 because I'm already too nervous and too anxious. Finally, it's 11 o'clock. I enter the details. I press enter. Site jammed. Mumbai University, you don't get anything at the first attempt. Take two. I enter all the details. I press enter again. Suddenly, my phone rings. I shudder in that moment out of shock. I receive the call. It was my friends calling me to tell that my school batch results have already released. And the result is 99.99%. Which means one student has failed. And everybody thought that Krishna has given his exam just studying for a month. He would have failed. So they called me to console me. I lost my shit in that moment. I shut my phone down. Already in my head, thoughts started creeping in. What if you failed? You'll be such a loser. People are going to talk bad about you. What is everyone going to say? I just covered my ears. I calmed myself down. I sat in front of the PC again. I entered all the details. This time the page was loading. 50, 60, 70, 80, 100%. The result was in front of my eyes. Name, Krishna Iyer. Exam number, so and so. Remark, pass. I just went there and hugged my mom. Because this was a moment of victory for me with myself. Nobody could ever understand how big this was. Very late in my age, when I was probably 24, is when I discovered what is my calling in life. In spite of doing college, degree college, I was never sure with an ambition. At 24, I figured out that I wanted to become a storyteller. Slowly and steadily, I started pursuing it. I didn't wake up one day and quit my job. Let's do only storytelling. No. Rather, last to last year, I lost my father. As a result, I started sharing the responsibilities of my family with my brother. But even that did not deter me from pursuing my passion. And today I stand in front of you here. The reason I bring this story in front of you today over here is that the society is always going to expect you to follow a rule book. They are always going to blame you irrespective of you following their rules or they are not of you not following their rules. You have to be the one who chooses your path. You have to be the one who owns your responsibility. The examples of successful people cannot be the parameters of deciding your timelines. You walk on your timelines. Let the fear of missing out not teach you what you are missing out on. Today's social media is yesterday's Sharma ji ka beta. In conclusion, I would just like to say, it was in 2008 when the doctors told me within 6 months my eyes should open. Today it's been more than 10 years. The eye still has not opened, but the vision has definitely expanded. Thank you.